So let's get the basics out of the way of this figure. This is a Walmart exclusive US figure, which to date, as of kind of mid-June 2022, has never been made available anywhere else other than occasionally, I think very briefly, through the UK, generally global site, but more or less UK-based Zavvi.com. Which again just had a little bit of a kind of input to some places in the around the world, predominantly though the UK. 6-inch figure, 15 centimeters, and so it was a very, very limited release. These Clone Wars figures, ultimately, I think the marketing behind this figure, if you were able to get one, should, if they have any common sense, questionably, but if they have any common sense, we will get this figure again in standard packaging of some kind down the line as part of a Clone Wars line of figures. They would not miss the opportunity to do this, hopefully, you'd think. They have before, but hopefully not. The packaging on this is reminiscent of the original Genndy Tartakovsky figures, those non-movable but oh-so-sweet-looking figures. Beautiful kind of art, the way that they've done again and captured this in the packaging. Just really looks in the 3D effect of the explosion behind. So nicely done. Very much a nice blast to the past. Those tiny little Genndy Tartakovsky little shorts, which everybody was setting their VHS recorder for way back in the day. And that is pretty much it. We get some nice art on the back. And again, that just fabulous show. It really was, I think, one of the best Star Wars shows ever made. Really just so stylish and so cool. And we still have so much to thank for it. And even the Clone Wars overall, pretty much, thanks to this, because it was successful. So, look, it looks pretty smart. We get some text if you want to freeze frame. But that's the packaging. If you want to keep in the packaging, that's fair enough. Personally, I had to crack this out to get a look at it. It is just, it's a great figure. It looks really good. There are a couple of flaws. One rather kind of major, but we'll get into that in a second or two. However, comes with quite a few weapons and accessories, and let's get the review part done before I have a rant, and boy, I am going to have a rant. Anyway, it comes with a couple of bits and pieces. We get a standard kind of DC blaster pistol or rifle. Looks pretty good. Standard stuff, all black, no chromium or anything kind of done up. Yeah, what to be expected, I think, to be honest. We get two smaller pistols, and you should be no stranger to these by now. Basically, Captain Sexy Rexy pistols. We've seen them on lots and lots of other clone troopers and others in the past. And one huge big rifle overall. Again, very Clone Wars authentic and fits very well. So you're no shortage of guns on the figure. It's got a rotor on that, on the rangefinder, I should say. And that is pretty much it. Backpack is glued on pretty permanently, it seems. We get some silverish paint going on there. And that is about it in terms of kind of detail paint. It's all pretty basic. Completely white clone, no weathering at all. Red trim around there, which is nice and sharp. Sculpt is great. We've seen this sculpt several times before now. Most noticeably, again, on, I think, what was another exclusive Clone Trooper on Echo. So pretty much reusing a lot of the parts and pieces, belts, pouches, repainted, etc., etc., etc. They could really reprint these things for days, and I think most fans would be happy if we could buy them. because it just... I'm trying to hold off the rant. Again, pretty solid articulated figure. We've got some good articulation up at the top there with the joints and the butterfly joint kind of almost inside. Really well done. Nice articulation at the elbows. Pretty decent. Nice range. And that double joint. We've got nice usual wrists back and forth. Waist. Pretty good considering all of these armaments and pouches. Up at the top of the thighs, you've got a thigh swivel up there too. Double joint to the knees. Rocking ankle. Pec holes. Very shallow. But, standard figure, here's the negatives. The helmet is not removable, and yet they painted the damn face underneath it. Well, not all of it, but sculpted it in the plastic. It is not friggin' removable, and that really drives me nuts. Especially when they already did this. Why would you not do it again for an exclusive figure? But nope, glued the effer on. really, truly annoying. This, I honestly think, is a Tamura rights copyright issue here, or some kind of fee. Every time they show his face, they've got to charge because this is getting ridiculous. I really just. Oh, I really want to swear so much, actually. It just really, really crappy that you go to all this bother. You even sculpt it in a different color of plastic, and then you cheap out at the last minute. It's really crap. Really, really crap why they did this. Now, let's blast back to 3.75 inch figures. When you bought one figure, you basically got two different helmets, a swap out belt, and a removable helmet. So this original figure came with two helmets, one swap out head, the head is in there. Swap out, the pauldron would swap out. You could then have this sash on him because basically it was Captain Fordo, this ARC trooper. It's the same figure that they've redone or reimagined here to basically, aka, reuse this mold. That's okay. That was fine, but the blasters were different. But no, we're getting the same old blasters to cut costs. The helmet to cut costs, and it's an exclusive figure which. Sold out in minutes, was so badly marketed on StarWars.com with the crappy little thumbnails and just terrible. When the product was actually pre-orderable and available to pre-order, they just did an image. They didn't actually have an image of the figure. It was just one of the shoddiest releases, and of course it was Walmart, so there was cancellations. I don't think even some people have actually got their figures yet in some cases, but what is an absolutely hugely massive fan figure, buggered at the release by the exclusivity, buggered by the kind of cheapy little bits and pieces where they couldn't really give the blasters that really went with the figure that they did in the vintage collection, and then just everything about it, just it ruins the experience overall. And this is what we've talked about on the 6-inch show time and time again. There is nothing wrong with this figure, nothing wrong with it. It is a very solid figure. Great articulation, it is effectively a reuse of other previous molds, and I'm okay with that. But just the shafting of the head, and just that was the final straw in this one. And the fact that it has just been such a royal pain to get hold of, only thanks to incredibly good friends who put up with all my crap, were they able to purchase this and help me out. And I think I did actually manage to get one at Zavvi just after it quickly kind of disappeared. After we found out, because again, when press releases come out, they only announce where it's available in the US. Everyone else, go screw yourself. They don't really care. And that is understandable because the markets are too small. But it's just, I'm getting really, really fed up with the line. I'm a diehard fan of he's been running a blog site. Met Hasbro several times, interviewed them many times, do videos, podcast reviews, and I'm just the constant utter shafting of the Black Series line, just the snippiness and the cutting corners and lame releases and just no love being put in the line is just really bringing this to, I won't say close to the end of the line because I will always buy a clone trooper because, well, I have a mental problem, I think, but fed up with this line. I'm really getting fed up with it. I really truly am. Great figure. I'm so glad to get it. But just, and you're like, why would you even, why? Why would you glue it? Has to be a cost mechanism. There has to be. I'd love to hear an answer for them, and I will ask them the next time we meet, but what do you think of this figure? Whinge alert, I know, I know. But when you've had such solid figures in the vintage collection, less plastic, less overall, less size, easier cost for distribution, less weight, so it's cheaper for distribution, but yet you get less. Something is wrong with this line in the Black Series. We know about it, we've talked about it, you guys have talked about it, but it's just, the line is just beginning to suck like nothing on earth. Endless, countless, carbonized, silverized, credit this, bounty that. Oh my goodness, guys, get it together. You're losing it. You really are. Now, you may be getting sales and you're just laughing at me, saying, well, whatever, people are buying it. Might be, but I see lots of people buying stuff less and less and much more peg warmers. They are not going deeper on the line, but it's a shame, real shame. This is a really solid figure. It could have been exceptional. It really could have been. Could have been a deluxe figure. The two helmets, the proper weapons. Nah. So, I don't know. I'm just fed up. I'm having a rant. I buy tons of Hasbro. I do shows about Hasbro. I'm not putting them in the gutter, but I'm not happy. Let us know what you think about this rant and rave. Sorry for the whinge, but another solid figure. Kind of borked again, sadly. But let us know what you think. If by any chance there's any left at a reasonable price, we'll put a link underneath in the description below. There's probably no chance of any fan channels ever getting this. And again, of course, because it's Walmart, had this been a fan channel, we all could have got some all over the globe. No issue. But money, money, money. It's all about the coin. So let us know what you think. We'll see you for more videos coming up soon.